Evet, şimdi bu integer valued real random variable için the generating function of x is given by this series. And corresponding to this series we define an analytic function basically wherever it is convergent. Okay, so if this real numbers, any series like this has a radius of convergence. If that radius of convergence is not zero, then in some ball of positive radius, this will be an analytic function. And the proposition below is about that function. Okay, if G sub x z is absolutely convergent on the closed unit disk. So if the radius of convergence of this power series is one or bigger, then it will be convergent on the unit disk, right? Yanlış yazmışım galiba, ifadede bir sıkıntı var. Bakayım. Ha, yok, if yok burada, ben yanlış kopyalamışım. Statement is that this function is absolutely convergent on the unit disk. Okay. Ha, şöyle. Therefore, it has analytic derivatives. So it's an analytic function derivatives on the open unit disk. Which is given like this. Then şöyle diyeyim, also the nth derivative is given by, of course, since this is an convergent power series, derivative is just can be computed term wise. So derivative will be just this. K times k minus 1 up to this and then k minus n. So here I mean the nth derivative which gives what? The nth derivative evaluated at zero is just n factorial times p n for all n in n. Okay, now let's see why this is the case. Actually, before the proof, we have. No, this is easy, I guess, right? Okay. Bir dakika. Burada Şimdi radius of convergence'ın finite'lığı nereden geliyor? Ha şeyden okay, I guess the statement is like this. So for u equals zero, this is just right when u equals zero, this is just this summation. And if this is finite, if this is finite, then of course you may put one here. So it means it will be convergent for complex numbers with modulus one. And therefore the radius of convergence of this will be at least one. Therefore it will be convergent not only for complex numbers with norm less than one, but also for complex numbers equal to one, with norm equal to one. So I guess we just need to know that this is convergent for u equals zero. But for u equals zero, this is already convergent because this is a sum of the probabilities of a partition, right? So this sum is finite and it's equal to one, right? Because you just decompose your space into subsets. Measurable subsets, and then you take measures of this each subset and you add them up. So this sum is just one actually. Therefore, this series is convergent for all z with norm less than or equal to one. So maybe we can just write that down. Since g x zero, which is just sum of these, sıfırdan mı başlıyor? Bu sıfırdan başlıyor. Sıfırdan sonsuza ve bu da bire eşit. The series g x z p k z z to the power k from 0 to infinity is convergent for all z less than or equal to 1. Okay. Dolayısıyla da radius of convergence'ı bunun en az 1. O yüzden de yani bu işte türev alabilirsiniz vesaire vesaire. And in particular gxz is convergent ya da yani convergent olduğunu söyledik. Analitik on this region. Boundary'de olmayabilir çünkü hani belki boundary'de continuous olacak ama hani analitik olmayabilir. Onu bilemeyiz. Alright. Okay, now for the next result we have a lemma before that result. So-called Abel's lemma. This is from actually advanced calculus. Sometimes I prove this in 349 as an application of uniform convergence. It's not a trivial thing, you know, that's why it's, you know, called Abel's lemma. It is not trivial, but it is not, you know, difficult either. I don't remember the proof now, but it follows. It can be proved using uniform continuity, uniform convergence. Sorry. Assume that we define fx on minus 1, 1 open interval by the real power series and from 0 to infinity a n x to the power n supposed to converge on minus 1, 1 on the open interval if the series also converges at x equals 1, then the limit of f at 1 from left. So this is the limit this limit this limit exists and equals to this gadget. In other words, the function defined by this series is continuous at x equals 1. Yani eksi 1, 1 açık aralığında convergence'a ve 1'de de convergence'a. Şimdi eksi 1, 1 açık aralığında zaten convergence orada absolutely convergent oluyor. İşte continuity vesaire orada sıkıntı değil. Ama uç noktada continuous mu değil mi? O kadar açık değil. Abel'in yaptığı şey o. Uç noktada da bu continuous diyor. The second part. So the first part is actually known as Abel's theorem or lemma. The second part, assume that for all an integer, an's are non-negative, and this sum is finite. No, just this sum is finite, sorry. An. So this is like the one we considered about the sum of the probabilities is equal to 1. It's convergent. And let f of x denote the series a n x to the power n, which converges for all x minus 1, 1. Değil mi? Bu toplam sonluysa eksi 1, 1 açık aralığında convergent olduğu bunun bariz. Şeyden dolayı, ratio testten dolayı. Değil mi? Ratio test Atıyor muyum? Yok. Ratio testten değil. Yani şöyle, daha doğrusu ratio testten, evet. Ratio test ne diyor? Bir tane radius of convergence var. Onun içinde convergent diyor. O radius of şeyin içinde. Dışında divergent diyor. Dolayısıyla burada x yerine 1 koyduğumuzda convergent olduğuna göre, o zaman radius of convergence 1 veya daha büyük demek. Çünkü 1'den küçük olsaydı 1'de bu serinin diverge etmesi lazımdı. Dolayısıyla radius of convergence en az 1. O halde eksi 1, 1 aralığında bu convergent ve continuous. Yine tabii uç değerlerde işte convergent olup olmadığını kontrol etmek lazım. Tamam. Then f this limit exists and equals to this gadget. Of course, this is a consequence of the first one, because when you plug x equals 1 in this function f of x, you get the series and it is convergent. So by part 1, this function is continuous at x equals 1. And it means that the left limit at 1 is equal to the value of the function at 1. Okay, so proof I will not prove Abel's theorem. As I said, it is, you know, advanced calculus and it is not something trivial. So one is known as Abel's theorem. Second part two follows from one. Abel's teorem diyeyim, şunu lemma değil de. Abel de 27 yaşında mı ölüyor, öyle bir şey. Ama yani ölene kadar büyük işler yapmış. Okay. Now this one uses Abel's theorem. So let gxu be the generating function, defined above. For u -1 1 for n larger than or equal to 1 gx and derivative of this limit of the nth derivative at 1 from left. This limit exists if and only if the factorial expectation x minus 1 up to x minus n plus 1. This expectation is finite. In other words, if and only if the factorial moment, evet, factorial expectation değil de moment diyoruz, of order n exists. In both cases, In both case denmez ki, in this case denir değil mi? Bir tane durum var çünkü. Yani o so the derivative is just this factorial expectation. Şimdi by the proposition before the Abel's theorem this nth derivative the limit this limit exists değil mi? O şuydu it is this one. So this is convergent and so on. Derivative exists and so on. Here we consider complex case, but you just take real variable. Instead of z, you just plug real numbers. But of course, it will be convergent. And so the result holds also for real variables. Okay. So by Abel's theorem, this limit is equal to şöyle yazayım, pardon, sığmayacak. PK and that's the factorial so this is the if part if this is finite then this gadget is finite. Yeah, okay. Yok, burada şey tersine galiba. Şeyse derivative varsa expectation finite olduğunu söylüyor. Tamam. Bu varsa o zaman bu buna eşit. O yüzden de bu da finite oluyor. Tersine conversely if the expectation is finite. In other words, if the factorial moment of order n exists, then by part two of the above lemma. Pardon. So by the above lemma, this limit will exist and equals to this gadget. Aslında bu argümanları sanki zaten yaptık gibi, kullandık gibi, değil mi daha önce? Okay. Son bir başlık daha yapacağım. Sadece tanım vereceğim. Laplace transform of a real random variable. So this is the analog of moment generating function for non-negative real random variables. Böyle tarif ediliyor. You already know, I guess, what's Laplace transform from probably differential equation courses. This is just a probabilistic version of that, okay? Instead of there you use Riemann integral. Here you use probability integral. Let x be a non-negative real random variable with distribution function f sub x so that this is zero for x between zero and minus infinity. Okay. So it doesn't take negative values. Bu anlama mı geliyor? Non-negative. Evet. The Laplace transform of f sub x is defined by şöyle Laplace transform of x at s is defined to be the expectation of this function on R. So it is this gadget. Here S is any complex number with real part positive. Okay, so in differential equation course, we had defined this for only real variables, but actually you can use complex variables. But for convergence, you need this, okay? Real part should be positive because, you know, if S is, let's say, AIB, then e to the power minus S will be what? Will be e to the power SA and e to the power minus SIB. This has norm 1, right? Norm of this is always 1. Therefore, convergence is, you know, convergence depends on this expression. And here you want A to be positive number, right? This should be positive, so that this gadget will be small. That's why we have this. So that's the Laplace transform of a real random variable with non-negative values. We have a proposition. Which I will actually list the properties without proof. So for A positive and B non-negative, we have the following. Laplace transform of this is e to the power minus BS. Laplace transform of AS, and that is just BS, and then integral over R. Where FX S over A is the distribution function. No, U over A is the distribution function of AX. Second, it is again linear in the sense that, well, actually not linear, but we should say it is maybe a homomorphism, right? On one side you have addition, on the other side you have multiplication because of the exponential term you have. So let me state that x and y be independent, non-negative, negative, real random variables, then the Laplace transform of x plus y is this. For all S in this set R, which is nothing but the complex numbers with real part positive. Okay, so we denote that by this fancy R. Okay, so this means what? In other words, Lx plus y is the Laplace transform of what? Of this function. The convolution of the function variables x and y, z minus x d f x x. You can write it both ways. Dördüncü ünitede ya da üçüncü ünitenin sonunda şey diye yaptıydık bunu da. Yani bunun anlamı, yani bu f'in türevini alacaksınız. O zaman işte f çarpı g gibi olacak bu. Yani f of z eksi y g y gibi bir şey. Bu da bildiğimiz standart convolution olacak. O kısımları işlemedik maalesef. Okay. As a function of S, Laplace transform is analytic on this set. Its nth derivative is şöyle satisfies the R plus üzerinde again I guess you remember this from differential equations. If you multiply your function by x and take its Laplace transform, then you get the derivatives of the Laplace transform of the function. And the second one is basically this gadget evaluated at zero, or maybe the limit at zero from right. Yani sıfıra sağdan giderken, evet, L N S. Exists and is finite. Kim başka var mı? Finite, pardon. Şöyle koşul var. If and only if, only if the nth moment exists, and in this case this nth derivative of the Laplace evaluated at zero is continuous in the sense that it's equal to the right limit, and this is of course just just integral over r plus minus x to the power n df x. And this is the nth, yeah, we had defined this notation for the expectation of x to the power n, right? It is mn. Okay. Part C. Assume that the nth moment of F exists, then L admits the following Taylor expansion. Yani şöyle, pardon, şey yok. K 0 to n s to the power k, k factorial expectation of x to the power k plus higher order terms for some s for some değildir de. Bir dakika. For small olacak değil mi? Tamam. Yani değil mi o da? Tamam, bakayım şuradan bir. Tamam. Okey. Bunun ispatını vermeyeceğim. So we have seen basically two kinds of generating functions, right? One of them is given by integral e to the power ux times df, right? And Laplace is e to the power basically minus ux. Okay. I guess we may stop.